Welcome to Warn. Today we discuss F-22 Raptor Radar and APG-77 Radar key features. The APG-77 Radar is the F-22's primary sensor and is a long-range, rapid scan, and multifunctional system. A Northrop Grumman-led joint venture with Raytheon is developing the active element electronically scanned array radar. Northrop Grumman is also responsible for the radar sensor design, software, and systems integration. The APG-77 radar is an active element, electronically scanned, that is, it does not move, array that features a separate transmitter and receiver for each of the antenna's several thousand, finger-sized radiating elements. Most of the mechanical parts common to other radars have been eliminated, thus making the radar more reliable. This type of antenna, which is integrated both physically and electromagnetically with the airframe, provides the frequency agility, low radar cross-section, and wide bandwidth necessary to support the F-22's air dominance mission. The radar is key to the F-22's integrated avionics and sensor capabilities. It will provide pilots with detailed information about multiple threats before the adversary's radar ever detects the F-22. The APG-77 radar, a novel type of electronically scanned phased array. In what is likely to be the most advanced airborne radar in the world, individual transmit and receive modules are located behind each element of the radar array. The transmit function of the solid-state microwave module supplants the traveling wave tubes used in prior radars like the APQ-164. The active, electronically scanned array, ESA, configuration has a wider transmit bandwidth while requiring significantly less volume and prime power. The system represents about half the weight of an equivalent passive ESA design. Each of the hundreds of individual solid-state devices generates only small amounts of power, but the aggregate for the entire array is substantial. The F-22's APG-77 electronically scanned array antenna is composed of several thousand transmit/receive modules, circulators, radiators and manifolds assembled into subarrays and then integrated into a complete array. The baseline design used thousands of hand-soldered flex circuit interconnects to make the numerous radio frequency, digital, and direct current connections between the components and manifolds that make up the subarray. Northrop Grumman Corporation, of Baltimore, MD, has developed an improved manufacturing process for F-22 aircraft radar components. The new process could result in a cost avoidance of nearly $87 million on the planned production run for the aircraft. By replacing the hand-soldered flex circuit interconnects with automated ribbon bond interconnects, the first pass yield of the subarray assembly has been vastly improved. The APG-77 radar antenna is an elliptical, active electronically scanned antenna array of 2,000 transmitter/receive modules which provides agility, low radar cross-section and wide bandwidth. The radar is able to sweep 120 degrees of airspace instantaneously. In comparison to the F-15 Strike Eagle's APG-70 radar takes 14 seconds to scan that amount of airspace. The APG-77 is capable of performing this feat by electronically forming multiple radar beams to rapidly search the airspace. The system exhibits a very low radar cross-section, supporting the F-22's stealthy design. Reliability of the all-solid-state system is expected to be substantially better than the already highly reliable F-16 radar, with MTBF predicted at more than 450 hours. The APG-77 radar offers significant advantages over previous combat radars. Among its most attractive benefits is the integration of agile beam steering. This feature allows a single APG-77 radar to carry out multiple functions, such as searching, tracking, and engaging targets simultaneously. Agile beam steering also enables the radar to concurrently search multiple portions of airspace, while allowing continued tracking of priority targets. The low probability of intercept, LPI, capability of the radar defeats conventional RWR/ESM systems. The N/APG-77 radar is capable of performing an active radar search on RWR/ESM-equipped fighter aircraft without the target knowing he is being illuminated. Unlike conventional radars which emit high-energy pulses in a narrow frequency band, the N/APG-77 emits low-energy pulses over a wide frequency band using a technique called spread spectrum transmission. When multiple echoes are returned, the radar's signal processor combines the signals. The amount of energy reflected back to the target is about the same as a conventional radar, but because each LPI pulse has considerably less amount of energy and may not fit normal modulation patterns, the target will have a difficult time detecting the F-22. The F-22 and its APG-77 radar will also be able to employ better non-cooperative target recognition, NCTR. This is accomplished by forming fine beams and by generating a high-resolution image of the target by using inverse synthetic aperture radar, ESAR, processing. ESAR uses Doppler shifts caused by rotational changes in the target's position to create a 3D map of the target. The target provides the Doppler shift and not the aircraft illuminating the target. SAR is when the aircraft provides the Doppler shift. The pilot can compare the target with an actual picture radar image stored in the F-22's database. The Air Force expects to take delivery of the first aircraft with a new radar in November 2006, but the software needed to provide the robust ground attack capability will not be completed until 2010. According to a representative of the Director, Operational Test and Evaluation, DOTNE, the key to achieving a more robust ground attack capability will center on the integration of this new radar. A December 2005 report issued by the Defense Contract Management Agency stated that problems encountered during the test and integration of the new radar has added risk to the development program. Until software and integration testing in the F-22A have been successfully completed, we consider the design unstable, creating the potential for significant cost overruns and schedule delays. Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, Warn.